he was difficult. That's all it is to it. And he would even, I don't even know how to explain it. He would find stuff about me that bothered him, so he'd have something to focus his anger in on. And actually, at one point from the hospital, they had sent him to, you know, to talk to a psychiatrist that dealt with geriatric psychiatrist, because, you know, the problems are the same, whether it's geriatric or you're dying from some sort of a disease. And I did go with him at one time, and she asked him, she said, "What do you find that's the worst?" He says, "I'm angry all the time." "Well, who do you take this anger out on?" And he said, "I take it out on her." And she said, "Well, why do you think that is?" And he said, "Well, she'll never leave me." And, you know, it was funny because the psychiatrist looked at me and she said, "Do you understand what a big deal this is?" And I said, "No." She said, "He trusts enough, because he knows he can't stop himself. That anger is there, but he trusts enough that you're going to be there. You're not going to leave him." And I found that really, like, that was a really eye-opening moment for me, because I thought, yeah, why? How could you leave him?